All right, back again with yet another video, video 3. Like I said last time, I do the car tutorial. I wore this shirt for this case. So I'm gonna take you on an in-depth look at what I did for the car and basically how I did it. First of all, it was the hardest thing I ever had to paint. So I'll take you through this real quick. Like I said before, I don't like having hard lines on here, so I softened every line, went back and softened every line. As you can see, I still have areas I need to go back and work on, but for right now, I reached a good stopping point, and I want to let this paint dry so I can work on another area. So first of all, the hardest thing was actually getting the color pattern down for this. I wanted like a sort of like a lean type color on the car, because I had an idea of the paint dripping down on the letters, but that should turn out to be harder than I thought it would be. So I'm stuck with here. Fortunately, the color pattern came out the way I wanted it to, so I was happy with that. This part right here, all of this right here, these lines, they don't have any real like definition to them. That, I think that was the hardest thing I had to do, or putting these lines on there. And this, the grill for the car was definitely another one of the hardest things I had to do. Yeah. Shirt, the hands, and the money. So stay tuned for that.
I can't pay my taxes. Oh, First, we'll need a string. Stretch it good and tight. Plunk it. Now divide in half. Plunk again. You see? It's the same tone, one octave higher. Now divide the next section. And the next. Pythagoras discovered the octave had a ratio of 2 to 1. With simple fractions, he got this. And from this harmony in numbers developed the musical scale of today.
My daughter, you do find mathematics in the darndest places.
You can imagine how excited Pythagoras was when he shared his findings with his pals, a fraternity of eggheads known as the Pythagoreans. They used to meet in secret to discuss their mathematical discoveries. Only members were allowed to attend. They had a secret emblem, the pentagram.
Pythagoras, boy, put it in.
It was our old friend Pythagoras who discovered that the pentagram was full of mathemagic. The two shorter lines combined exactly equal the third. And this line shows the magic proportions of the famous golden section. The second and third lines exactly equal the fourth. Once again, we have the golden section. But this is only the beginning. Hidden within the pentagram is a secret for creating a golden rectangle, which the Greeks admired for its beautiful proportions and magic qualities. The star contains the golden rectangle many times over. It's a most remarkable shape. It can mathematically reproduce itself indefinitely. All these rectangles have exactly the same proportions. This figure also contains a magic spiral that repeats the proportions of the golden section into infinity. To the Greeks, the golden rectangle represented a mathematical law of beauty. We find it in their classical architecture. The Parthenon, perhaps one of the most famous of early Greek buildings, contains many golden rectangles. Same golden proportions are also found in their sculpture. In the centuries that followed, the golden rectangle dominated the idea of beauty in architecture throughout the Western world. The Cathedral of Notre Dame is an outstanding example. The Renaissance painters knew this secret well. Today, the golden rectangle is very much a part of our modern world. Modern painters have rediscovered the magic of these proportions. Indeed, this ideal proportion is to be found in life itself.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy. This is mathematics. I like mathematical figures like that.
Donald,
Get me to iron it.
No, no.
Ideal proportion.
Not quite. Uh-uh. No, I'm afraid not. Well, we can't all be mathematically perfect.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, I do like to do it.
Now that you're all pent up in a pentagon, let's see how nature uses this same mathematical form, the petunia, the star jasmine, the starfish.